I just finished my playthrough of Bloodborne on PC using the shared PS4 emulator, and I was surprised to see how well this is working now. Performance was stable all the way, and I only had 2 crashes throughout the whole game. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to set up the emulator and all the patches and mods I've used for achieving this. If you're planning on buying on Amazon, please use my affiliate link below in the description. Any product on the website will count and you will be directly supporting the channel. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is download the emulator itself. The link for this page will be on the description of this video. And this tutorial is for Windows PC, but this emulator is also available on Linux and Mac OS. But if you are on Windows like I am, you're going to look for the one that says Win64 QT. This is the nightly build of the emulator that has all the latest updates for it. So on the name, right next to it, you're gonna see a link, and this is the one you're going to download. Click on this link to download the emulator to your PC. So when you download the file, you're gonna notice that this will be on the zip format, which means that you have to extract this file. And you can do this with WinRAR or 7-Zip or the extracting tool if you are on Windows 11. I personally like to use 7-Zip, I'll put the link of that on the description of the video as well. And once you download it, it will be this file right here. So first, you're gonna double click on 7-Zip to bring up this window, and all you gotta do is just click on this install button, and in just a few moments, 7-Zip will be installed. Now you can extract shared PS4. And I put this file on the desktop of my computer, and it's best that you keep this file on places like the desktop or the downloads folder on your computer. Just don't put it in places like the program files of your PC, because then you could get an error because you don't have the writing permissions there. But anyway, here on the desktop, you're gonna right-click the shared PS4 file. It will bring up this window, then you're gonna select 7-Zip, and then you're gonna click on Extract to Shared PS4. That way the files will be inside a folder. And there you go, this is the file right here. So you're gonna double click on that to open the folder, and it will look like this for you. So the first thing we're gonna do here is create a game folder. It's optional, but I like doing this way because we can keep things organized. So you're gonna click anywhere on this folder with the right button on your mouse, and then put your mouse on top of New, and you're gonna select Folder. Now, the name here can be anything you want. I'm just gonna put my as Game, so that I know that this is the folder, right? Because when we install the game, the files will go in here. And with that out of the way, we can start the emulator, which is this file, the application of shared PS4. So double click on this one to open the emulator. Right away, you're gonna see this window, which is asking you where you want the emulator to install the game. In this case, it will be the game folder we just came up with. So you're gonna click on this browse button, and it will open the emulator folder by default. So now you're just gonna click on the game folder once, and then click on select folder on the bottom. And also, you need to set the directory for the DLC, which is going to be the same game folder as well. So click on browse, and select the game folder once again. If you're going to use the Game of the Year edition of Bloodborne, you don't really need this one, but I'm just gonna set this one to the same folder in case you get the base game and is planning to get the DLC later. So now just click on OK, and the emulator will start. This would be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. Now, to install the game on the emulator, first I'm gonna drop the game and the updates file on the same emulator folder, which are these games files right here, the game itself and the 1.09 update. And you're gonna have to find the game and update on your own. They are both on the PKG format, so they are good to go. And to install them, you're gonna go back to the emulator, you're gonna click on File, and then select Install Packages. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you're going to first install the game and then the DLC. You have the option to install both of them in one go, but do not do this because you're gonna get an error once it's done installing. You have to do the game first and then the update. So start with the game, you just have to double click on the game file, And then it's going to ask you the directory where you want it to go. That is the game folder we came up with. So now you just click on OK. And then you're going to wait for the game to install. When it's done, you should see this message. So click on OK. And now you're going to see the game in here. Now let's install the update. So just repeat it. Click on File, Install Packages. Open the folder and double click on the 1.09 update. This one will be much faster. Click on OK, and it will say it has detected the patch. Click on Yes. In just a few moments, the patch will be there as well. Next, we are going to add the system modules to the emulator. So go back to the emulator folder. There should be this folder here called User for You. Double click on that. And inside, there's going to be this Sys modules folder. Double click on that. And this is where you're going to drop the modules files. There are a bunch of modules files for PS4 out there, but the ones you're gonna need for Bloodborne is these ones right here. There are 9 files, and the thing is, you actually don't need these modules to play Bloodborne on the emulator. They are not required to play the game, but there has been reports from those who play the game that having them with you actually makes the game run better and even crash less. But there's also people who claim that the game crashes more with the modules. And there is also reports that the modules made no difference to them. When I did my playthrough, I had them enabled, but I also tested the game for about an hour or so without the modules, and it was pretty much the same. So there is no clear answer right now on whether you should or not have them. It could be hardware related, so you need to test it yourself. And just like the game, the modules are copyright protected, so you're gonna have to find them on your own. So now back on the emulator, I'm gonna show you how to enable the cheats and patches. The patches are very much required to play the game right now. So you're gonna click on the game with the right button and select the cheats patches option. This window will pop up, and the first thing you're gonna do here on cheats, on the bottom, you're gonna click on where it says Wolf 2022, and you're gonna change this to Shed PS4. Then you're gonna click on the download cheats option. This window will show up, click on OK, and here you're gonna have the cheats you can use in game. You actually need to start the game before activating these patches. If you click on them right now, the emulator will actually tell you that. So you just need to have the game running before you activate them. Now head over to patches, and you're gonna do the same thing. Click on gold hand and change this to Shed PS4 and select download patches. The window will pop up again, click on OK. And here we have the emulator patches for this game. And the patches I'm gonna recommend you to use is Skip Intro, which is self-explanatory, no harm in activating this one. And also the 30 FPS fix. As you know, the original game is 30 FPS on the PS4, but it has some inconsistent frame rate. And this patch right here will lock the frame rate at 30 FPS. Which is also how I would recommend you to play the game right now, because 60 FPS can make the game crash more. We're gonna get into that in a little bit. But this will also introduce some input lag on your game. So if it's something that's bothering you, come back here and turn this off. Also, click on Disable Chromatic Aberration and Disable Motion Blur. Now, with this patch, you can play the game at 60 FPS, if your PC can support that. But on this emulator, when the GPU usage is too high, that's when the crashes are more likely to happen. And the only reference that I can give you here is my own, because I play the game at 1080p 30 FPS, and I have a RTX 3070 as a GPU. So the usage was about 50 to 70%, and I only had 2 crashes, like I said. So at 60 FPS, it crashed a lot more. Just make sure that you turn off the 30 FPS before turning on the 60 FPS one. Now moving on, click on Force Enable the Old Hunters DLC. Regardless if you have the Game of the Year edition or the DLC in a separate file, because this is currently the only way to play the DLC right now. Below that, click on Disable VSync. This will help a little bit with the input lag on the emulator. But you should only disable VSync if you have the 30 or the 60 FPS patch enabled. Otherwise, it's gonna speed up your game. Now scroll down to the bottom and you're gonna see the resolution patches for this game. And just like on the PS4, these games run natively at 1080p resolution, so that's why you don't see a full HD option in here. And when I played the game, it was at 1080p resolution. And it works fine as long as you have a decent GPU, like I explained on the 60fps patch. So if you have a weaker GPU, then I would recommend that you play the game using the 720p resolution patch. Of course, the game will look a little worse with it, but it will use less GPU, so perhaps you won't get a lot of crashes. Just like if you have a better GPU, then you can try with something like the 1440p resolution, for example, and see how it performs. But for stability purposes, it is best that you play the game at 1080p or bring it down to 720p resolution at least. And when you're done, don't forget to hit the save button, and there you go. Click on OK and you can close this window. Now I'm gonna show you how to apply the mods on the emulator. So head back to the emulator folder and we're gonna head over to this place. On your game folder, or the folder you created to place the game, you're gonna double click on that and you should see a folder with this name, that is the ID of the game, the region of your game that is. Double click on that. Then double click on the DVD root PS4 folder. And there you go, this is the place right here. Before dropping the mods themselves, the first file I'm gonna recommend you to get is the generic mod enable for Bloodborne. It is this file right here, and I won't be linking you directly where you can find the mods because they often have copyrighted material in them, so it could get my video striked. But I'm gonna show you the names of each one of them. For the mod enable, it is this file right here. So you can just double click on this file and then it will open on a separate window. So in here, you're gonna double click on this JSGME folder and you're gonna need these files. So you can just select everything here, press and hold the left button on your mouse, and then you're gonna press and hold once again and you're just gonna drag these files on the folder and then just let go of the button, and then the files are gonna be in here. You can delete the original zip file now. You're not gonna need this anymore. Make sure you close the window, otherwise you won't be able to delete the file. Now, the mods that I have used are these ones. The SFX Fix for All Effects, also known as Alpha BB. The No Cloth Physics, also known as Rain Spike Workaround, and the Vertex Explosion Fix. They can all be found on the same place, and for a couple of them, you need to install them separately, but for the Vertex Explosion Fix, we're gonna use the mod loader, and that's the one I'm gonna start with it here. So you're gonna press and hold this mod, and you're gonna drag it to the mods folder we came up with, and then double click on the mods folder and extract this one. Right click on this file, select 7-zip or WinRAR depending on what you have, and then click on extract here. You can delete the original zip file now. So go back to the DVD root folder and you're gonna start the JSGME application, that is the mod loader. This window will show up and you're gonna see your mod showing up in here. So now you're gonna click on it once and then click on this arrow in the middle so that it goes into the activated mods section. And there you go, this mod is working now. So you're gonna close this window, and for the other two mods, I'm gonna start with the Alpha BB, that is the SFX Fix for All Effects. You're gonna double click on this file to open, and then you're gonna see a DVD root folder, just like the one we are in here. So you're gonna double click on this one, and then you're gonna see the SFX folder. You're gonna drag this folder in the DVD root folder here. So just press and hold the button, bring it to the folder, and then let go. Now you're gonna see this window, click on replace the files in the destination, and just wait until it's finished. There you go. You're gonna do the same thing for the No Cloth Physics mod. Double click on that, but now you're gonna see a MTD folder. So you just do the same thing. Press and hold, let it go, and then click on replace the file in the destination. And that's it. That's how you get the mods in here. Now let's head back to the emulator because we're pretty much ready to start the game now. And for controller support, this emulator supports pretty much all the PlayStation and Xbox controllers out there, and even third-party ones, but there is currently no keyboard support. Unless you're using a software that allows you to emulate a controller through your keyboard, then there is no way to play the game with a keyboard right now. There's not even settings for controller mapping, that's something that is being worked on, but if you just plug in your controller, you can play the game just fine. Also, make sure that you have the auto update enabled so you get the latest fixes for this emulator. Click here on settings and then select configure. And on this window, you just want to make sure that you have this option marked here so that you get the updates and also on the nightly channel as well. Click on apply and then save. So now to start the game, you just have to double click on Bloodborne. This window will pop up, and to go full screen, you have to press F11 on your keyboard. And with the game running, this is the moment to activate the cheats if you want. Right click the game, cheats, patches, and you just have to click on each one of them you want to use, and there you go. When you go back to the game, they're gonna be working. I have many emulation tutorial videos like this on the channel, so if you like what you saw, don't forget to check out my other videos, subscribe to the channel, and also leave a like on this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.